Love that song. Well, when I went out today, Apple Music just put on the original version by Duran Duran, but the Lord of the Lost version is my favorite version. Before I get started, hello. It's good to be back at work. It's been a minute. Oh my God, I love this. This is Chris Hemsworth. I think about this every single day. It actually boosts my confidence and self-esteem.
You're absolutely correct.
I'm not a fuck.
Hey, you. Yes, you. Today is your day. You got this. You're absolutely crushing it at everything you do, from your job to maintaining a social life to pursuing your passion project. You are killing it. Ignore anyone who tells you otherwise, because you're amazing. The only thing more beautiful than your smile is your personality. Yeah, I said it. You're more than capable to take on the world, the whole world, by storm. Speaking of the world, did you know that it's a better place because you're in it? I mean, your mum brags about you all the time. Dogs love you. You're strong, you're confident, you're intelligent, you're charismatic, you're the total package. On a scale from 1 to 10, you are an 11. You make me want to be a better man. You're bloody brilliant. You're brilliant. Don't forget it, okay? Do not forget it. And go out there, take the day by storm, and remember this. I'm proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Hey, you. Yeah.
So lovely. And he's so handsome as well. And he said, I'm 11. Even though, like, today I feel like a six. But thank you very much, darling. That's very lovely to hear. The reason why I'm late, I was supposed to be on here like hours ago, but I wanted to get my nails done. 'Cause I don't like being on here when my nails, aren't done. They're all chipped in. Didn't look good. I was listening to music when I was getting my nails done. I think this color is just so fly. It's called Embarrassing Red, and it's by a brand called Jella or Bella, and it's SNS. There was a dirty ass comic that was doing a video, a terror video, and it was entitled, the title of this video was called You Had a Miscarriage Because Spirit Didn't Want You to Have a Baby with This Person Because He Is a Male Escort. Now, for one, I wasn't pregnant. Thankfully, I misread the whatever you call it, the negative and like the lines for positive and negative. Now, if I was pregnant, if I go and get a fresh pregnancy test tomorrow, because the pregnancy hormones would still be in my body, it would come back negative, because like those hormones linger around for a little bit. So thank goodness, thank goodness. And I checked my app for my cycle. It's like a few days off, but it's regular, it's healthy. I still haven't changed my mind about wanting to have a surrogate because I don't want to go through pregnancy or childbirth. So, if you were a psychic or a reader, you would have known that. Unfortunately, this isn't going to be a very nice video that I'm going to make. this is going to be about what I have seen, about there are sirens going off in the background. About some very, very nasty police officers that have been tasering grannies, elderly people, I should say. And I need to address some pedophilia that I've been witnessing. So, on Sunday, this isn't for children, so please, I don't want children to be watching me. But if you are a parent and guardian and you feel like you do need to speak to your child about this, parent, guardian, do so in your own way and in your own time. Thank you. Now, police commissioner I am not scared of you at all. I don't scare and I don't intimidate, and I seem to thrive in chaos. So you actually you actually fuel the fire that's inside of me. So I'm just going to let comics, criminals, be my footstool. This wasn't the first video that I saw, but this is what has happened just recently. Everyone is talking, well, not everyone, but lots of people. This is being spoken about worldwide. So this is from The Project. It's just like on The Project YouTube page. It says down here The Project. So this video is called 95-year-old grandmother tasered by police is fighting for her life.
Great grandmother Claire Noland was a lover of knitting, a devoted Christian, and a daredevil. She went skydiving for her 80th birthday.
She's still sometimes very sprightly. I would suggest a very intelligent lady and one who...
I will put this in a link in the description down below. I don't know how to do that thing where you can... I'm not good with technology. I'm with the basic things. I can't put the video, on the screen. I don't know how people do that.
Who has kept the community at heart?
Now, the 95-year-old dementia patient is in Cooma District Hospital with a critical head injury after police tasered her 2 days ago.
She was approaching police, but it is fair to say, at a slow pace, she had a walking frame. But she had a knife.
Today, police revealed Claire had taken that knife, a serrated steak knife, from the kitchen at her home in the Yallambee Lodge care facility in the early hours of Wednesday morning before entering a treatment room. Staff then called emergency services before Claire was tasered. Police now investigating the case as a critical incident.
An injury that leads to death or imminent death and with exceptional circumstances in a level one critical incident, the homicide squad are involved.
Body cam footage of the incident is so confronting, police say it's not in the public interest to release it.
No officer, not one of us, is above the law, and all our actions will be scrutinised robustly and from a criminal perspective.
Clearly the police force, whatever training they're getting to de-escalate a situation, is not filtering down, and to resort to tasering somebody as a first response is completely inappropriate. Disability advocates now questioning how a 5'2", 43-kilogram elderly woman could have been subjected to such drastic action. It just raised more questions than answers as to how could this have happened and what steps are going to be taken to prevent it happening in the future, because something has to come from this. This is absolutely shocking.
This story, like, when you hear it, it's just so shocking, and I've kind of spent the whole day waiting for some kind of mitigating circumstance, some kind of explanation that makes it make any kind of sense. And it just hasn't come. I can't understand it. I can't get my head around it. What happened?
It's like usually with cases, right? It's like the more information you get, the more we have answers, the more answers you get.
Yeah.
But with this one, the more information we get, the more questions we have, because you heard it there from, you know, the police going at a slow pace, had a walking frame, 5'2", 43 kilograms. How does this happen?
Yeah,
it's shocking.
Yeah, it's awful. It's really, really awful.
More answers to come.
So, the body cam footage is so disturbing. It's not in the public interest to release. Okay, let's really think about this. So how much is 43 kilograms? I don't know. I'm bad at maths. I think it's like 2.5 kgs. No, 2.5. I don't know. Hang on. I can do this. I would have to say about 80 pounds. Unless I should have probably prepared myself first before I got on here, because this is not professional whatsoever. Okay, so 43 kilograms. Uh, 94.799 pounds, according to Google. So that's not much. Most people, that's nothing at all. I can deadlift that at the gym. So a very, very old lady, 95 years old, weighs 94.799 pounds. In a walking frame, with a walking frame because she is so old and brittle, holding a steak knife against two police officers. Now, I know that police officers have to be physically fit to join the force. It would not have been hard, especially with someone that has dementia that's in a walking frame. So, without tasering, I could have grabbed her wrist firmly without causing any injury to her bones, and I could have snatched the knife out of her hands. If I needed help, I could have just gotten someone to grab her from behind. So, like, you know, restrain her and then remove the knife from her hands. Because, you know, police are equipped with bulletproof vests and all. She would not have caused any harm whatsoever. Now, I remember this has happened a few times to me, and I'm quite young. When I was in hospital, when they put me into hospital last year, because of all the medication they were giving me, like Abilify, and they were giving me heavy pharmaceuticals before I requested that I want melatonin because it's natural, it will help me sleep. Because there are a lot of patients that were screaming at nighttime, so they woke me up. And also the nurses, they do your checks when you're a patient in hospital, like every hour. And I woke up in the middle of the night and I had no idea where I was. I was so scared. But then, like, after a while, you know, I don't know how long, a couple of minutes, you know, I knew who I was and where I was. But I was so scared. Now, dementia patients, from what I know about dementia, is they wouldn't know where they are or who they are or what they're doing most of the time. So I can understand why she would be scared for her life and to grab whatever weapon she could to protect herself, just in case. So if I was a nurse, I could understand that. I would definitely be compassionate, and I would definitely accept that. Now, it's unfathomable. So police commissioner. Is her actual name Karen, or are people just calling her a Karen? I don't know. I don't care what your name is. You are just a cockroach to me. You look like a cockroach. You are a cockroach. So I don't care what your name is. I'm just going to address you as what you are, which is a cockroach, a runt, police commissioner. That's just the nicest names I have for you. I put this on my community board yesterday. New South Wales boss, New South Wales police boss. I'm so sick of all of you. New South Wales police boss hasn't watched body cam footage of 95-year-old tasering. ABC News. It's cold. I'm going to close the window. Is anyone else like me where you have to have the whole house to be freezing cold? And then when it's cold, you then have the nerve to say that you're cold.
Days after being tasered, Claire Nowland is in a
Hang on, should we pick? I'm going to assume that everyone has already seen what this. Claire is the name of the victim that's now in hospital with brain injuries. So her brain is... Oh, that's my doggies. Her brain is bleeding and her skull is fractured. So she would have fallen quite hard. But yeah, that's what she looks like.
Condition in Cooma Hospital.
I went in yesterday about lunchtime and offered.
I'm so sorry. I'm just not organized today. I'll start off from the beginning.
5 days after being tasered, Claire Nowland is in a dire condition in Cooma Hospital.
I went in yesterday about lunchtime and offered to say mass with Claire and the family at her bedside.
She has shown us that she's very resilient, but I don't think the prognosis is very good.
Its name is Karen Webb. Does suit you.
The Homicide Squad investigates the New South Wales Police Commissioner has been doing a media blitz. Was the use of a taser appropriate?
That will be determined by the critical incident team.
Karen Webb still hasn't watched the body cam video of the tasering.
I want to do that when I have a complete picture of what happened. I don't see any value in reviewing that footage now.
Nor has she seen this vision of Rachel Graham being handcuffed in 2020.
Oh, help!
The then 81-year-old's family sued police.
If that and other matters point to the need for us to review our training and adapt our training around this, then we will do so.
Ms. Graham's daughter told the ABC she's disappointed the commissioner hadn't watched the video of Ms. Nowland's tasering.
If they don't watch the footage, it's a failure of courage on their part.
Well, I'd argue the opposite. I think it takes courage not to view it.
Are police the right people to be responding to an uncooperative or even violent person with dementia?
That's a big question, and I don't have the answer immediately.
Ms. Nowland's family has just released a statement describing Claire as a loving and gentle-natured matriarch. They said it was a distressing time for the family and thanked everyone for the outpouring of support from around the country and the world. Alexander Lewis, ABC News, Sydney.
It takes courage not to view it. Karen says. Yeah, you are, Karen. Natalie Barr. Hang on, I commented on something last night.
New South Wales police have questions to answer after a 95-year-old woman, Claire Nowland, was tasered inside a community nursing home in Cooma
Well, she held a steak knife. The dementia sufferer is now receiving end-of-life care with brain bleeding and a skull fracture. Joining me live is New South Wales Police Commissioner Karen Webb. Thanks so much for your time. People are rightly asking this morning, Commissioner, what happened? Do you have an answer to that?
Well, we've actually determined what happened, but really the point now is why it happened, and that's the work of the critical investigation team at the moment, to really work through from the moment or even before police turned up on that night and responded to the call from the aged care facility and ambulance, and what led to the use of the taser on Mrs. Nowland. So again, as I said, I understand that the community want to know what happened, and I want to know, as they do, why it happened. And we really need to take the proper course of action, make sure that this investigation is done properly, thoroughly, and that Mrs. Nowland and her family get the answers that they deserve.
Yeah, absolutely. And I respect that process. But, Commissioner, do we really need an investigation to tell us that this 95-year-old woman with dementia using a walking frame shouldn't have been tasered? I mean, in what circumstances would that be okay? Are there any?
Well, it's the first time I've ever heard of it or seen it. And as I said, we know that it has happened, and it's terrible. But I really want to know why it happened. And that's really, we're not going to know until we review all of the evidence and consider it in light of the policy, procedures, the training, and whether the officer himself makes comment about it.
Yeah, I mean, we can see the circumstances on face value. I respect that there needs to be an investigation here, but, I mean, the best case scenario, if I can put it that way, do you just think the officer panicked?
That's it. That goes to that question of why, and I don't have the answers right now, and I'm as keen as the community of New South Wales, Australia, to find that out. But we can't rush that. I can't interfere in that investigation, and it would be improper for me to add pressure to the investigators to get those answers. But as soon as I do have answers, then I will provide an update.
Is it right to even question at this point why an officer would need to take a taser into an aged care home?
Well, our officers are equipped with a number of appointments that can be used to resolve a situation, and the officers are trained to use those items, but they wear those items on their uniform all the time that they're on duty, so they don't get to select what items they take to what job, and the officer though makes a choice at that time.
Oh my god, so I know that, well, I don't even know where these places are. I don't know where Coomer is. But I just looked in the background of where Karen is. Look, it's the Opera House and the Sydney Harbour Bridge. So, what a coincidence. What a coincidence. Because there has been a massive crime wave in Sydney.
And based on the circumstances. And that goes to that point I made about understanding why that course of action was taken on that morning.
Have you spoken to that officer?
No, I haven't. And I will do at some point. As I said, it's an ongoing live investigation. He is being looked after by police from his command. Mm-hmm. And when it's the appropriate time, then I will speak to him.
Okay, so the reason why you haven't spoken to him is because it's now part of an investigation. You don't want to prejudice that, is that right?
Well, that's part of it, and the officer's currently not in the workplace, so he's being looked after by the commander in that area and staff around him.
Have you spoken to Claire's family?
Yes, I have. I met with Claire's family on Friday. I visited the family while they were at the hospital, and I spent some very good time with them. I talked to them about the process of the investigation, but really the privilege I had was to just listen to the family talk about the great life and the great things that their mum did in her very full, rich life. Mm. And she had a very rich life. Lots of children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, but really a strong community-minded person and often put others before herself. So it was really heartwarming to hear those things about Mrs. Nowland.
Are they angry at the New South Wales Police Force and this officer?
Well, no doubt that will come, but at the moment they're just focusing on their mum, and rightfully so. They want to make every minute count with her, and they're all supporting each other during this difficult time.
You say you're not going to watch this body cam footage yet, but you have been told about it. If the circumstances in this footage have been relayed to you, why not just watch it?
Because I want to make an informed decision based on access to the whole evidence. The body worn is evidence in this investigation. Mm. And if I viewed that now without having the opportunity to view all the evidence at one time, then it may taint my view of this matter. It is important that I take an objective view, and I will do that when I get the rest of the evidence and investigation.
But if it's already been relayed to you, how's that objective?
Well, I haven't watched it, and if I need to watch it as a decision maker at some point, I will do so.
Okay. People are angry about this story. They are so exercised about how a 95-year-old woman could be at the end of a police taser. Do you understand why people are angry? And what do you need to do as commissioner to, I guess, restore faith in the force?
Let me just say, I understand the way the community feels, and I really want the answers as much as everyone else does, and we will get those answers. That will just take time. And if it is that we have to change our training, our practices, etc., then we will do so. However, I would like to say that we have over 2 million calls for service every year, and this is one event. This is not about loss of confidence of the whole police force. I have over 18,000 officers across this state protecting our community every day, every night, and they do an excellent job. This is one matter that I will consider in its full context.
Yeah. Commissioner, do you have a view of whether the aged care home should have called police in the first place?
That's really going to be subject to the investigation, and I understand that our detectives will consider that in as part of their investigation. Mm. The call to the home, those witnesses in the home, including interviewing some of the residents of the home, which is a difficult task, the whole picture, and that's really what I'm looking forward to receiving.
Yeah, and Cooma is a small town in New South Wales. A lot of people will know this family. A lot of people will know that particular police officer. What's it done to the community there?
Well, I imagine the community is just wondering how it happened, like everyone else.
Yeah.
But it is a small, tight-knit community, and I know, meeting with the family, that they're just banding together to spend time with Mrs. Nowland, and we respect that they need to do that right now.
Commissioner, just one last question. The best case scenario here, I think we can assume that this officer made a mistake and he panicked. Is that your view of things? And with the investigation and its conclusion in the next couple of weeks, do you anticipate that there will be changes? There will have to be changes to training or something like that?
Yeah, I can't speculate about what happened, why it happened on that night. But if it does lead to a review, a need for additional training, different training in response to people with dementia or any other person with a cognitive impairment, then we will do so. I'm very open to the need to review our practices if they have to be reviewed.
Karen Webb, thank you so much for your time today. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Laura.
Karen Webb, the New South Wales Police Commissioner there, on that investigation and that shocking incident just 5 days ago when a 95-year-old woman was tasered.
Okay. And a troll commented. The username is Chris Hussack 445. Commented, okay, she's correct. She can't see it yet. For those who understand, if she sees it beforehand, before internal affairs investigate, she could be found to have a biased opinion. If she sees it now, the dirtbag will get away with it. That is a crock. Bullshit, hun. Bullshit. Before I get stuck in 21, listen to this. I cannot.
Well, the New South Wales Police Commissioner has made headlines this week.
This is Natalie Barr and David Kosh, Grill, New South Wales Police Commissioner.
After she revealed she has not watched the footage of an officer tasering 95-year-old Claire Nowland in a nursing home. Karen Webb told reporters she has no intention to ever watch the vision.
Meantime, there are concerns this morning. Sydney's gangland wars could be reignited after a man was shot dead in his car at Elizabeth Hills. Police found a man believed to have low-level links to the Comancheros inside a car. Suffering gunshot wounds, he died at the scene. Police Commissioner Karen Webb joins us now. Gee, what's going on today? Let's start with the shoot.
Karen Webb, just because you have a lazy eye doesn't mean that I can't tell when people are lying. I can tell when people are lying just by looking at their eyes. So you have not fooled me whatsoever.
Being overnight, what's the latest on that?
Well,
have you made an arrest?
No, I wish I could tell you that I have, but it's a very active investigation. Obviously, it only happened last night. We've got three crime scenes, the scene where the shooting occurred, and two burnout motor vehicles in different locations in southwest Sydney. So early days, very wide scope to the investigation, and we'll narrow it as we work through it.
In the middle of the day, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, pretty scary for locals. Are you concerned this could reignite Sydney's gangland wars?
Well, of course, we don't know that that's gangland related at the moment, and we'll consider all lines of inquiry. But of course, if it is, then that is a concern, and we will, you know, have investigators working around the clock on this to make sure that we can suppress any retaliation if that's a concern as well.
Was the victim known to the police at all?
Oh, it's too early for me to say, really. It's possible, but yeah, whether the victim was known or not known, we'll just investigate it like we would always.
Okay, let's look at the tasering of 95-year-old Claire Nowland. This story has gone around the country and around the world. It is shocking.
It is.
But one of the things that gripped everybody is your comment that you won't watch the body cam footage. Was that a mistake?
I find it surprising, actually, because I'm actually not the investigator. And the important thing here is that the detectives do their job, and we allow them to do their job without me interfering in that. If at a point in time I become a decision maker about the employment of the officer or the investigation, then I will look at the evidence as a complete picture, not just one part of it. So I think the point is I just need to let the process happen. I need to maintain the integrity of the investigation, and if I interfered in any way, then that may prejudice an outcome. And certainly Mrs. Nowland and her family deserve better than that.
So is that the norm, even though it's such a high-profile case, getting lots of coverage, you don't get involved at all, you don't want to know about it until the troops on the ground actually complete their investigation and it comes up to you?
That's right.
You don't take an interest at all?
Oh, I take an interest, and I get briefed on it every day. And right. I've certainly been interested in this, and it's a shocking matter, and I've never seen anything like it. So, of course, I'm interested, but I need to let the detectives and all the specialists do their job.
But so you've never seen anything like this. It's shocked the whole country. It's made news overseas. What people don't understand is why you're not interested in watching that. You don't have to comment on it. You can still let the investigation run its course. But why you didn't feel the need or the want to look at that footage is astounding people.
I just think that the detectives need to do their job. Whether I watched the video or not is not going to make this investigation go any quicker. And I think that's the point I'm trying to make, is I need to let these detectives and the investigation team do their job without worrying about who's seen it, who hasn't, and let's deal with the facts. No speculation. This is such an important matter. The community have every right to know exactly what's happened. So let's just let the detectives do their work.
Because it is astounding to a lot of people that, number one, a 95-year-old could be tasered in the first place. What sort of threat could she have been on a walker?
So we know a little bit about what happened, and that's been, you know, commented on so far. But what we still don't understand is the why, and that's why it's important that detectives really work through the why and try and understand. And there's no point me speculating either, and I don't know why the officer...
It's a few days now, still no reason why.
I think the detectives,
no idea.
The detectives have the statements from nursing home residents, staff, ambulance, police witnesses, etc. Our next step is waiting for an expert opinion from the weapons side, and I really need to the investigators need that for next steps.
Yeah, and fair enough. But you know what was interesting is when the other family came out from the St. Basil's Randwick case that happened 3 years ago, kind of a similar case where an elderly patient ended up in hospital, and the family there came out and said that they could not convince the police force to have the officers in that case undergo mental health training. So it feels like
we've got extensive mental health training. In fact, when I review the records, and I've called for a review of us and our training around dementia in particular, but we've been training officers on dementia back to 2006, 2007, and our mental health training package, which is quite extensive, started in 2020, even predates that, and it's quite an extensive program, and we're always reviewing it. And of course, if there are needs to be a change to that training, then we will update it. You know, one of the concerns, I guess, for me is that police officers are being called to private facilities or public facilities to deal with dementia patients. I think that's a concern for me, is that the role of a police officer seems to be growing wider and wider, you know, and we're expected to know everything about everything, and we're not experts on everything. So we try and prepare our officers to deal with all sorts of situations, but I do worry that we're being sent into a situation that wasn't resolved by staff, wasn't resolved by others, and then we get called as a last resort.
Yeah. Have you spoken to the officer involved?
No, he's currently not in the workplace. And I'll probably speak to him at some point. And my concern at the moment is with the Nowland family. This is a terrible time for them. They're going through a lot, and you know, they've got my thoughts and prayers with them.
Should the officer be charged?
That will be a matter for the investigation. And again, I don't want to prejudice that investigation, and we just need to let the detectives do their job.
If you're worried about situations like this happening, if there's an elderly person in a nursing home brandishing a knife, who should be called in if not the police?
Well, I know there's been questions, I'm relaying questions that have been asked previously. How is it that someone can get an access to a bladed knife when they've got dementia? So there's a lot of questions that
happen. I mean, terrible things happen, as you would know, every day. So that happens. What should the nursing home people do if they don't call the police?
Well, it's a question about how they're trained and prepared to deal with that in the first instance, I guess. You know, what training do they have to deal with those situations? Dealing with anyone with dementia is difficult. You know, anyone that has a family member with dementia knows that it takes special care and attention. So, you know, it's a last resort that they call the police. And so that will be borne out in the investigation.
Yeah.
Yep. Very tough. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Karen Webb, thank you.
Shut up. I swear to God, bitch. Swear to God. If I have to see you, hear your voice ever again, I'm going to flip the coin. There's sirens going off in the background as well. Now, I cried a lot when I saw this. If you haven't seen this, this is very distressing. So if you don't want to watch it, then you should leave. It broke my heart when I watched it. Well, that's just a preview. Okay, so this was released very recently. This incident happened in 2020. It's now 2023. So this is a video shows nursing home patient Rachel Graham being handcuffed at St. Basil's. I've never heard of St. Basil's. Where is St. Basil's? St. Basil's Aged Care in Kensington. So that's very close to me. So the next, like, this, like, immediate area, there is, to get to the city, there's Kingsford, then Kensington. In Sydney, of course. Now this is an elderly. From what I know, this other woman, she was 81. That was just my security camera. Like, when there's movement, it lets me know. Okay, so just take a deep breath. Sorry. I'll just have to turn the lighting up on my phone. So video shows nursing home patient Rachel Graham being handcuffed at St. Basil's. So this is Sydney Police. So the closest police would be Maroubra Police. My area.
While police are trying to be caring.
Don't twist your arms. Yourself,
Rachel. It is abundantly clear Rachel Graham is terrified of them.
Get away from me.
Confused.
While he was out getting a new parcel.
I'll ask for an ETA.
In pain.
These ones are looser.
They haven't.
And it's clear that the police who handcuffed a 45-kilo, 81-year-old dementia patient were making her worse. Mrs. Graham had taken an ID from a staff member at St. Basil's aged care home and was, as dementia patients are, aggressively holding on to it.
Try take it.
We showed this video to the daughter of a St. Basil's resident.
Mind-blowing. I mean, most of these people, they don't know what they're doing either.
It happened in 2020. The Graham family received compensation and released these pictures because of the tasering of 95-year-old Claire Nowland, saying the force has learnt nothing. Mrs. Nowland remains critical.
I can assure you that the best homicide detectives are investigating this matter.
And the body cam video will not be released.
It is a matter for the police and it's a matter for the LEC to work through those issues.
Yesterday, Police Commissioner Karen Webb said this.
So it's not routine and we don't intend to release it.
The day before, her Assistant Commissioner said this.
It is not in the public interest to be releasing that.
And while police often have good reason to withhold video to preserve the independence of witness accounts, they do release it sometimes if it's in their interests. June 2020.
Get back! Get back!
Another in 2020.
Let go! Deal with it, you
2021.
A senior constable on the receiving end of a violent assault.
All examples of body cam released within a day of police being assaulted. Rachel Graham's family had hoped her encounter might lead to an inquiry, and now with Claire Nowlan too.
But if there's ways in which that we can do better and get our frontline officers to understand more about the behaviour of people with dementia, that's important.
Robert Abadia, 7 News.
Yeah, so it's either Bondi Police, so Bondi, like, or Maroubra Police would have had to go to Kensington, but I'm pretty sure it's Maroubra Police that would have dealt with Kensington. Yeah, what a coincidence. Did you all see where 6 police officers, 6 fit, not fit as in, like, you know, that term for, like, you know, someone's good looking, physically fit, in shape, with strong bones. Restraining an 85-year-old dementia patient for taking a nurse's ID badge. Let me get this straight. So 6 of you handcuffed with 2 sets of handcuffs. An 85-year-old dementia patient for taking a nurse's ID badge. And while she was handcuffed with 2 sets of handcuffs, you tasered her and she was screaming. Did McDonald's spike my cappuccino? Am I high or something? Am I high? Do I have the correct facts? Is that what I heard, or am I just imagining it? I want to believe that McDonald's spiked my latte. I'm high as shit. and I don't have the correct facts. That's what I want to believe. It's actually, because, dirty, like, there are a lot of cops that are involved in this, so Karen, the cockroach, it is within the public interest because I said so. Just because I said so. For that body cam footage to be released, but I'm going to assume it's extremely brutal. Now, as per your contracts that you sign, because you have to sign when, you know, you have to sign off that you have, like, a weapon. And in your contracts, it states black and white, clear as crystal. Crystal clear. That's... police can only open fire if someone is threatening them, they are a threat to the community. You cannot use a taser on the elderly and disabled. And why would that be? Because when people age, their bones get brittle. Gravity takes its toll. Muscles atrophy. And why isn't dementia going to be as common nowadays than it is with people that are currently 80, between 80 and 100 years old today? Because of research. Research shows that it's a lack of protein in the brain. And also, it's aluminium. So people that were, when these people were young, they ate a lot of food that came in aluminium cans. They cooked in aluminium pots and pans. And that is a... big contributor to dementia. So the reason why Karen hasn't reviewed the footage is because she is defending crooked cops that are involved in trafficking rings, organ trafficking, child sex trafficking, and there's also a lot of killing people for insurance. They assume like, their targets are weak people that can't defend themselves. And I just noticed that a lot of bullshit happens. Like, it actually starts with police. So these, yeah, because if she died, she would have had to be been taken to the Prince of Wales Hospital. But these two patients have family, because, yeah, Prince of Wales is, like, the closest hospital to Kensington. Prince of Wales Hospital is in Randwick. This was in, yeah, Kensington. And a lot of bullshit has happened, like, with Prince of Wales Hospital. But they have family that love and care about them, so, yeah. So, Karen Webb, is making a mountain out of a molehill. So, the investigation. Let's do the investigation. There is body cam footage. There is body cam footage which would have shown how it escalated. I mean, if she came at the officers with a knife, they could have easily taken that knife out of her hand. No problem whatsoever. So, you know, that's the only way to see, like, you know, how everything escalated. And why they actually use a taser. But considering that there is bleeding in the brain, I can just imagine, like, how brutal it is. Now, so tomorrow I'm going to be doing a pregnancy test, if I was pregnant at all. Yeah, like I said, those hormones would still be in my body. And what you're coming at me with is, threatening my parents. Threatening my parents to give them, to give these fuckheads, my wallet that has my bank card in it, that has my Medicare card in it, that has my ID in it. Now, they did that to make it look like I conveniently left my wallet somewhere. Just conveniently, which would have, to put, like, because they've opened another bank account under my name, which would have had to come with it, which came with an ATM card, and other shit in it, to make it. Because when you check into a hotel, you need to show them your bank card and your ID. So they've done stuff like that. And commenting on things to make it look like I've got post-traumatic stress disorder. And I'm taking drugs, apparently. And to pay for these drugs, I am now blackmailing people on Tinder soliciting sex, and yada yada yada. Now, calling me a prostitute, or because I was formerly a prostitute, that is correct. That is 100% correct. And at least I've got no intention or desire to get money off of other people's deaths or their insides. Sex work is still work. But I don't do that anymore. Last week, you're also attacking my Instagram photos, and then trying to make me feel like crap about myself, so that I would have sex with someone to give me HIV, because I don't know if you already told everyone that this is just what you're discussing in your Nazi camp, because you are saying that I had a baby that died of AIDS, that was born drug exposed. What? Oh my god. Guess what, guys? You're not gonna believe this, but I took drugs once. I know, so bad. But then I stopped because they made me feel like crap, and they made my skin really bad, and that, like, this white thing, you know, the white thing in your eye, it was red, and I looked like salad fingers. So I was like, I'm just gonna stop now. I don't know, because I haven't been through this ever. I'm going to assume that if a baby was born drug exposed, it would have to be in ICU for a while. I don't know. But considering how big that baby was, it looks quite healthy. It looked quite healthy to me. But it didn't come out of my vagina. So, yeah, you like to attack, you seem to be attacking people that are very weak, like babies and elderly and disabled. Yes, having dementia is, well, I can just imagine. It would be a pretty brutal disease to have. So just what these morons were talking about I was trying to meditate the other day, but I couldn't because I just kept on laughing. Was they quote, "Let's make it appear to the world that she's broken. So we're going to do this to make it seem like she's taking drugs and she's doing this to pay for her drugs. And then we're going to say that she overdosed," or something like that. And there was another thing about psychologically, they actually mentioned specifically commit suicide. They said, if we do this, she might commit suicide. And these people can have her organs. And these are all the insurance policies, blah, 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 blah. And there's always, like, you know, so many different plots and different plans. But yeah, because I remember when I called Prince of Wales Hospital because there was something about me being on fentanyl, like there was some BS that they had made. It looked like it was coming from me where I said that I'm suicidal and I'm taking fentanyl, not to treat me for cancer or some shit. So if I was suicidal, I probably wouldn't have gone to see a GP to give me a referral to the hospital. I wouldn't have told anyone. I wouldn't have bothered to see a doctor at all about the pain that's going on down there. And second, I remember when I tried fentanyl, and I remember I couldn't get out of bed for like forever. I couldn't breathe properly either. It was like really, really, really like shallow breathing. It was like, and I couldn't comment on anything on YouTube because my body was like so weak. Anyway, but you know, when someone says that they're suicidal, it means that they're going to die soon. And when people are saying that they don't want to be treated for cancer, so they're trying to make it look like I'm going to die soon from not having cancer treatments, it's a very, very like sick and twisted. It's because I know too much. You spastics haven't asked me how do I know. Thank you for asking, because I know everything. See, I need a break. Yeah, how is it she knows? That is a question. None of your business. Now, apparently, if you talk about this, the penalty is a $250,000 fine, or if you protest against it. Put on my tab. I'm already paying off like so much shit anyway, so it's not gonna make a difference now. Well, there has been, I'm not gonna watch any videos. I've already posted on my community board. There was something about having drag shows for children, dressing them up in drag. And there's something that I've seen where, I don't know what you call them, transsexuals, transvestites, are doing drag shows in front of children. Now, that is disgusting. It's pedophilia, as far as I'm concerned. It's pedophilia. It's wrong. Okay? Yeah, I mean, I put myself in danger fighting for equality for you. You are not going to play that card with me. You're not going to play that card with me at all. You're not going to play that card with me. Now, yes, I've said it's pedophilia. Because you're sexualizing children. And I know that when I want to have children, I already know how I'm going to raise my children, and I want to preserve their innocence as long as I can. If they want to transition, if they want to change gender, fantastic. I'll pay for everything. But it won't be until you're 16. Until they're 16. Now, what happened previously? When we were having beauty pageants for children, JonBenet Ramsey, what happened to her? Evidence shows from the trauma in her vagina that she was sexually assaulted right before she was murdered. And a detective that was being interviewed, I think it was on Dr. Phil, can't remember, she said, judging from the trauma in her vagina, she was six when she passed away, I believe. And the detective said that it was more than once, judging by how it looked. And there was a pubic hair found in her underwear. Recently, they have found that. And she was absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I mean, like, you know, parents do think. I think that's harmless. They're having a bit of fun. Can't. We can't. We cannot. There are too many sickos out there. Way too many sickos out there. We can't do it. No one is not going to know what my children look like. Only close friends and family, but no one is going to, like, know what my children look like until they're, like, you know, 10. Well, when I feel like they're developing and they have pubic hair, if I have a girl, when she starts growing breasts and pubic hair, because I know that she's now turning into a woman, so a pedophile won't, you know, find her, won't be sexually attracted to her, just for their own protection. So in my opinion, we have Mardi Gras for drag queens, but not in front of the kids, like not the drag strip shows. Fuck off. Now, the reason why I am not happy with this whatsoever is when I was doing a video last year when it was Mardi Gras season, and there was something that was going on in America where they weren't going to pass the bill. And you were making it very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. For the transgender community around election time. Even our former Prime Minister Scott Morrison had a problem with transgenders, and I put that in a video that I watched. But when it comes to children, dressing them up in drag and having drag shows with children, and then you are threatening people with $250,000 fines if they protest against it. So you're trying to legalize pedophilia, and then you are threatening that if people object, you're going to fine them massively. It doesn't sit right. It's sick. It made me sick in my stomach. It still makes me sick in my stomach when I think about it. When I think about all the times that I've done research, what is this person doing? What's going on over here? Why is that happening over there? So you're making it difficult for adults, right? Passing laws. You're making it difficult trying not to pass laws so that people can have a sex change. But it is okay, according to these morons, that children are allowed to dress up in drag and perform in drag shows. and to do drag shows, drag strip shows in front of children. No. Doesn't wash with me. Spiritual advice. Oh dear. Those are my doggies snoring in the background. They are so cute. Oh my god, I feel so bad. So this morning, the other morning, Charlie was so excited to see me, in the morning that he fell off the bed. And this morning, oh my god, I think I was a little bit rough with him, like I was pushing him away, but I usually push him away, gently, but I didn't see, what part of his body that I was moving. And, I pushed, his throat, pushed him on his throat away. And I feel really, really upset. I hope I didn't hurt his feelings. So, this is why I feel a little bit, yucky today. We need some music. I've not heard this song in a while. And it's fun.
Just take hold. Put your cards on the table, baby. Do I twist?
So, I just remembered with them comics. Get out of my face. You're pissing me off. This is so delicious. This is peach green tea with no sugar. Otherwise, it's too sweet. And coconut jelly with these fuckheads. Oh, beg your pardon. With these fuckheads. Yeah, the bitch from the legal aid that I spoke to yesterday, she didn't send me that information because I told her about a conversation that, about a group chat that I have saved. Because she was asking me, like, I just remembered something else. When I called those fuckheads at the hospital and I said that if you come near me, I'll shoot you. I said, if you come near me, I'll blow you away. Now, the next morning, two coppers came into my home. One was, like, really hot. It was a guy and a chick. The guy was really hot. The chick was lovely. She was so sweet. I could tell she wasn't, you know, the C word. And so this drunker asked me, the hot one, he's still a drunker though, if I'm suicidal, because I threatened those fuckheads that I was going to shoot them. And then I was like, no, they're just, like, making up lies that I have cancer and blah, 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 blah. So I think they're trying to harm me. Now, so that happened on a Wednesday or a Tuesday or a Thursday. Can't remember what day it was. I don't really fucking care either. Then on the following Friday, which was my before my appointment at the hospital, because I want to have this, because I got polycystic ovary syndrome, which is fucked. I hate it. I hate, like, it's annoying to live with. And because of, like, you know, their lies that I've got cancer, because, like, they want me gone. You are fuck ugly, bitch. You are fuck ugly. And another one called Areola or something like that. Areola. So Areola and this old cunt, old lady that calls itself like Christine Dengate. She called me last year and she was like, the police are so worried about you. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway, so she wrote in a report that I deny having ovary cancer. Now, she came into my home and she was like, because she was stewing on something. Like, you know when people are, like, trying to hide something or get away with something? She was, like, she came to home and she was, like, you told us that the hospital had stolen your ovary. Blah, blah, blah. And I said, no. I said, you're trying to sell my organs. So she wanted to take me into hospital. She came in with the papers to put me into hospital. But my mum told her to, like, get fucked. So, yeah, Kensington, St. Basil's at Kensington is, like, the closest hospital they would have, had to take this woman into was, the Prince of Wales Hospital. Now, I also called the Prince of Wales Hospital because there was something about me, like, someone pretending to be me saying that I was saying that I'm suicidal and have and am taking fentanyl, yada, yada, yada. So then I called up the hospital and I said that a police had come to question me about this. And so she was like, did you get the name of the officer? And I said, yes, I did. And she said, okay, well, call them because, like, they listen to my phone calls. So they want to know if I have anyone on my side that's in the police department. I'm not stupid at all. And I do not scare. I do not intimidate easily either. Now, I also called up a lawyer because I wanted to take legal action against people that have multiple life insurance policies under my name. Now, almost immediately after I had called that lawyer to see what I could do to take legal action against Prince of Wales Hospital, someone from the physio department called me and said that my appointment with physio is at 8:30. So I called to confirm. I have an appointment in the gynecology department at 9:30, but they want me to come in at 8:30. So they're messing around with my phone, commenting on things on YouTube. And then, like, making appointments based on the comments that they're making on YouTube. What the fuck? But why would you want to come? Like, why would you want me to? You already know what I think of you. So I wouldn't trust you with anything, like, in terms of like mental health, if I am struggling with mental health or with anything, I wouldn't want you fuckheads involved whatsoever, because you're fuckheads. I wouldn't trust you as far as I can spit. And also, there's a receptionist that works in the gynecology department. And she is the one that was calling herself Lottie Smith. And a lot of people were saying that Lottie Smith runs the department, blah, 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 blah. The exact same voice, the exact same accent. And then when I confronted her, she was like, well, Lottie Smith doesn't work here anymore. Yeah. I'm sure, bitch. So anyway, you're corrupt. It's to do with, like, these organ trafficking. And they want me to know to just keep standing my ground. I don't back down. I consider myself a real-life superhero. So, fuck off. Yeah, whatever. Go and comment on shit saying that I'm traumatized or I'm this or I'm that. Whatever. Don't think anyone's gonna believe you. But if they do, then... oh well, I really don't care, to be honest. I don't care if they believe you or if they don't. Because I know me better than anyone else. Like, what fool can tell me anything about myself better than I can? Nobody. So fuck off. I'm really tired as well. Actually, what does Seven of Wands mean? Where's Madeline?
Certainty. Sadal. Hi, welcome to Contemporary Tarot. I'm Madeline, and in this session, we're going to be looking at the Seven of Wands. The Seven of Wands upright represents someone seizing a project or an idea. It represents strong communication, bravery, valor, standing up for what you believe in, picking your battles, communicating what you believe in no matter what the cost. This represents putting effort or work into a project. It represents committing to a specific project, especially if you have many options in front of you. The best course of action with Seven of Wands upright is stand up for what you believe in. Commit to a project. Choose. Seize the day. If you are stymied by choice, trust yourself and make a decision and begin. Get started, launch, proceed. Stick up for yourself or another. Get into the game. Test an idea to see if it holds up. Overall, this represents taking action, speaking up, declaring yourself. And so you're using your power, strength, and communication to forward a project you believe in. The Seven of Wands reversed. This represents hesitant...
Well, it's not reversed, it's upright. If it were reversing, we'd be looking at the meaning. So this is all I'm going to be talking about today. I'm going to leave it right here. As for these, dorks. Yeah, you are dorks. Aw, Faith No More, We Care A Lot just came up on my page. Thank you. That's so sweet. Yeah, so, you know, attacking, there was also someone near the Prince of Wales Hospital that has dementia, that had dementia, and that was close to my appointment, at the hospital as well. So, I mean, I've been a patient at the Prince of Wales Hospital. I was in there last year. That place is Fort Knox. I thought of many ways, like, to escape, but none of them worked because, yeah, it's very difficult to get out of there if you are a patient. So, yeah. It's, you know when Peter from Type Negative, the love of my life. Anyway, when he said in that interview, when he was like, it is just unbelievable how people treat each other. Yeah, it is unbelievable. So, as for these dorks, these bunch of turds, yeah, you are a bunch of turds. This coconut jelly is delicious. Yeah, because that happened, again, coincidentally, in my area. Well, now you're going to be meeting me. I am unarmed. I don't have any weapons. I don't own any weapons. Well, you know, there's steak knives and things in the kitchen. But I do weigh more than 90 pounds. You sickos. So yeah, my spiritual advice was Seven of Wands, which was stand up for what you believe in.
Things are
Yeah. Well, I don't really have anything else like to talk about. I'm really sad at all of this. Yeah, I am very, 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 very sad. It is very sad. Like, who in the fuck wants to hear or see or know about an elderly person being tasered? Who? Someone fucked up and evil, that's who. Also, I'm just stating facts here. I don't care if you call me fat, chubby, slut. I've heard it all. Don't really care. Remember when, from the Prince of Wales Hospital, this came from you, that I had genital herpes. And there was a big thing about it. And, well, as Dr. Britton says, Fanny. I've seen a lot of Fannies. It's so funny. That turned out to be, BS, because I showed everyone my Fanny. As much as I was comfortable, where Slimy Mantha stabbed me in the rib last year is still a bit sensitive. And that turned out to be like an absolute crock. That, like, the picture of like my Fanny and that Fanny were not the same. And, you know, a war has broken out. Trafficking and poverty is at an all-time high as well. So how do you think these people feel knowing that over a lie like that has happened? Ow. And a law firm called Howard and Howard were trying to create a controversy around my, or like around me, because they were representing, well, people were trying to get them to sue me. Except for these people. Hang on. For one, I've caught them like many times hacking my phone. They're also involved in trafficking, and they murdered like some people. One of their murder victims' name is Elizabeth. So I think they're going to drop the, I'm pretty sure they're going to drop the lawsuit and back off because they know that I will... They know that they won't be able to win against me anyway. Also, these trafficking rings that I'm apparently associated with here in Sydney, so some cops have, like, put together camera footage, but from what I've seen, it's just me in the videos, because if they leak any other camera footage, like, if they put out any other camera footage showing, like, this person's face, you know, people are going to wonder why, like, they're not in the community. And I can tell you're hacking my phone because it's glitching right now. So I'll find out later exactly why you are hacking me. There's no way that I could be doing anything anyway with my phone when I'm shuffling cards. So that's pretty dumb. And the time is 3:06 p.m. Oh yeah, it's on my phone as well as 3:06. Okie dokie, so that's all for today, folks. The most important lesson out of all this is just to treat each other with love and kindness, because this looks ugly. It is ugly. Okay.